I think all of you know what this is. But do you know what this is?
This is a clinical thermometer. When you're sick and you want to know your temperature, you put this under your arm or into your mouth and measure your body temperature. This is a thermometer for measuring the condition of your penis. When you have erectile dysfunction, you can put this on and you can gather data how it is working and whether it could be sick. Welcome to UroChannel. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist, and in this video, I am going to explain you what this little thing can do. As always in my videos, if you have personal health problems, go see your local doctor. This is not medical advice. I'm just informing you about medical conditions. So this thing is something that you put onto your penis using this little strap. And when the penis erects during the night because you get these nighttime erections, the strap will expand and the sensor will record this expansion, sending this to an app, which will then generate a report which tells you anything, like how many erections did you have per night, how many minutes combined did you have erections per night, how was the quality. Very interesting stuff, and of course, I tried that myself.
It's time to go to bed, and I'm very tired, so I will mount this thing onto, you know what? And in order to do that, you just pull it out here and you place it onto the organ. And of course, you have to remove this adhesive tape before that so it stays on. So I'm very excited to see what comes out of it. Good morning. Night is over. I slept well. To my surprise, that thing didn't slip, so it stayed in place all through the night, and I had to go up and go to the bathroom once. They say in the manual you should take it off, but I hadn't the power to do that, so I just left it there, and it was possible to go to the bathroom with this thing in place. Incredible. I didn't notice it being there, so it didn't slip. It stayed there all through the night, and now I have uploaded the data onto my smartphone. I can't show it to you because I'm filming with my smartphone. And the app told me that now the team is going to process my data and I will receive a report later in my email. So I'm very excited to see that.
Before we get to my results, I would like to address one thing. I went through the YouTube analytics the other day for 2024. And to my surprise, out of all the viewers who watched my videos during 2024, only 3% were subscribers. I think subscribing or sharing videos or giving the videos a thumbs up is like the applause to an artist or to a lecturer. Just imagine you go to a lecture and you hear that lecture and there is a room full of viewers and in the end, only 3 of 100 applaud. That's rather sad for the lecturer. I've never seen this happen. I've never delivered a lecture that bad that nobody applauded. So I would really appreciate if you would subscribe to UroChannel and give the videos a thumbs up because this is my applause to the content that I'm creating. Thank you very much. Now, what about my results? I'm afraid I won't tell you. First of all, I'm a doctor, right? And it's never about the doctor. It's always about the patient. So doctors never talk about their personal health stuff. Secondly, I don't think it would do you any good because my results were ridiculous. My penile age was so low, it would make you envy. I don't want that. The question of the day is, who needs this kind of sensor? Let's start with me as a doctor. I am electrified by it. It's useful both for clinical settings and for research. In clinical settings, when I ask my patients, do you have nighttime erections? Very often I receive something like, I don't know, because they are sleeping, they wouldn't remember. And sometimes you don't have erections in the morning hours, then you wouldn't remember either. So it would give me valuable data when a patient comes to me with erectile problems. If this patient has a serious issue with erections, just telling from nighttime erections. For research purposes, I think this is just fabulous, because when you do research on erectile dysfunction, usually you rely on questionnaires. It's the IIEF5 questionnaire, the International Index of Erectile Function, or the SEP3 question that we give out, but this is qualitative data. With this gadget, you can get quantitative data. So you get minutes, you get numbers. This is very interesting for any kind of research that we can do. Of course, this is not the first measurement device of its kind. There was one that was primarily used in research units, like you would have to put the patients into bed, you would have to hook them up and to tell them not to move, and you would get some kind of data. So it's very impractical. But now you can pretty much hook up everybody and you get data very easily, and data of high qualitative standard. The question of the day is, should you as a private person own one of those? They are for sale, so you can go ahead and buy them. And if you are a health tracker and you want to track every aspect of your body, or if you are in rejuvenation and want to measure your progress, then you might consider buying it. It's not very cheap, but the quality of the data is very high. Or if you're having erectile problems and you want to measure your erections, then it might be useful. But as a rule, it's not something anybody would like to own. Maybe if you want to go ahead and tell your friends at your party how your erectile age is, this would be very useful. Or for dating, you can approach the date of your choice and tell them that your penile age is 22 when you are 47 or whatever. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.